Hi YouTube, Michigan Snow Pony Renee, and I'm just giving you a little update on these gardens. I got my front beds pretty much planted up, and now I'm working on this section here where my potato bags are going to go, and I'll show you those bags in a minute. I was just going to put down landscape fabric with these leftover cement blocks, and my husband said, no, you can't leave it out exposed to the sun or it'll disintegrate, so you have to put something over it. So luckily I had the truck today because my daughter had a riding lesson, so we had to haul the horse to the riding lesson. So I thought, well, I've got the truck, I'm going to go up to the hardware store and get some bulk mulch, and that's what I did, and now I'm unloading it. I don't think I got enough, we'll see, but I'm going to cover it up with this mulch and then set the bags on top. So and then I'll show you more about these little bags that I got. Okay, I've moved over in the shade. I want to show you these grow bags, these potato bags I got. They were from the lakesidecollection.com. If you go online, it's kind of a cheesy novelty catalog filled with a bunch of, dare I say it, crap made overseas. But I saw these and I thought, okay, they were like $7-$8 a piece, and I thought, for that kind of money, I will give them a try. And I was pleasantly surprised. They're a little smaller than what I'd liked, but not a bad size. They're about 24 inches deep, and they have grommeted drainage holes on the bottom, so that was good. And they also have built-in handles. Okay, I bet they'll rip the first time I try to lift them when they're heavy. Such an optimist. But the funniest thing, and I don't know if this will work, but I thought it was kind of funny, is they have a drop door. So theoretically, back here, theoretically, made in China, what's the price? It's Velcroed, and you can get your new potatoes out without disrupting the rest of the bag. And I'm going to have to put the camera down a minute and open this up.
Okay, I'll got the
drop door open. Reminds me of those old-fashioned pajamas, you know. And so the idea is that you can un-Velcro it when it's full, and when your potatoes start to flower, and get in there and get some new potatoes. Okay. I don't know if I'll use that feature, but I thought it was pretty funny. So I'll show you that. So if you're interested, you can try it. It says in the directions to put 3 to 5 seed potatoes in here, and I'm only going to put 2 or 3 because I just don't think the bag is that big. But I'm going to put 6 inches of compost in the bottom, plant my 2 or 3 potatoes, and then I'll just see how these hold up and how they do. And I think I got at least a dozen. I think I got 16 of them. So there you go. The lakesidecollection.com if you're interested to get your drop door potato bags. Well, I got 3 bags planted. A few more to go. If I can keep the chickens out of this mulch, I will be happy. I'm thinking about running some cheap fence from the privacy fence over to the grow boxes on either end, just to keep the chickens out, because chickens cannot resist mulch. Cannot resist. They are always digging in the compost pile, which doesn't bother me, it bothers Tim, but they will spread this stuff all over if they get into it, so I'm gonna have to figure out something. Anyway, that's what this is gonna look like with a bunch of bags down it. And this won't be hooped over, this part, just these boxes. So I'll just use this as a grow area until I figure out what else to do with it. So, okay, YouTube, that's all.